My name is Bruce Cameron. I'm the department head in the Textiles, Apparel Design and Merchandising program. What we're exposing the students to today compared to maybe what they were doing even 10 years ago is different. Things have changed. That's one of the things about the textile and apparel industry. It is constantly changing, and you have to keep up with the changes that are occurring. We have seen the sort of emergence of zero waste design, where you get the most out of your materials so that you're not wasting any of your fabric or wasting as very little as possible. So there have been a lot of initiatives that have come out of this sustainability idea.
Hi, I'm Donna Sapp. I'm an instructor and the undergraduate advisor for the Department of Textiles, Apparel Design and Merchandising. This is our body scanning lab. We have a 3D and 4D size stream body scanner. And with the body scanner, the changing booth basically is the scanning booth. And on the framework, we have infrared sensors. And those sensors, when you step into the scanning booth, those sensors will scan the body and they take over 400 measurements in a matter of 6 seconds, which is pretty amazing. And when those measurements are taken, they're actually going to form a very true to scale avatar of that body, and it's accurate to within plus or minus 3 millimeters. So it's incredibly fast and incredibly accurate to be able to gather the measurements of the body. So from our student standpoint, the benefit of that is that they can take those measurements and then draft a pattern using our OptiTech software and make a pattern that is specific to that body. Once the student has scanned the body, their model that they're going to be using, they'll take those measurements and take it into our digital design classroom. This is the digital design lab, and in this lab we have 24 computer stations that have OptiTex. OptiTex is a software package that is an industry specific software that allows students to draft patterns, so they are able to take their design ideas and actually turn them into a pattern by drafting it on the computer using the software. So the next step, after the student has scanned a body in the body scanning lab, they would then start the work of designing their garments. So this is an example of a design board with three different designs that a student has put together, indicating her fabric choices and the actual design styles. And of course, the images on the board are supporting the theme of what she's wanting to design. And so you get the feel of what the garment's gonna look like. And so she's done her initial sketching, but now coupling that with the body scan that she's taken, she can then draft a pattern. She comes over to OptiTex, which is the pattern software that we use, and she drafts her pattern. So if I indicate here, you can see there is the skirt front, and that's the skirt back. We have the halter top front and the halter back. And then of course we've got some small little pieces here that are facing pieces for both the skirt and the top itself. So you've got the pattern pieces, they've all been drafted. And traditionally what would happen is you would have to cut this, or actually you would plot it on our plotter. You would cut it out of fabric, you would stitch it together, you'd put it on a model, and you would test the fit to see if it actually is looking the way you had envisioned it. With the 3D simulation, you can use the avatar here. You can place your fabric. And so first off, what it's gonna do, it's gonna pop each of these pattern pieces on her in the position that they should be, and then you're going to say stitch it together. And if you watch very closely, you'll see that all of a sudden it's starting to take shape, where it's being virtually stitched together the way it is intended to fit. It's getting all of the fit down. It's even placing buttons and buttonholes where they're supposed to go. And once the simulation is complete, you will see the way this pattern is actually going to look on the body. So in a matter of seconds, you have tested your pattern to see, oh, that sleeve is not near as full as I wanted it to be, or it's not as long as I wanted it to be. You can tell that almost instantaneous, instead of having to go through the process of cutting and sewing. Now, with our avatar, you can look at her and see if it's very tight or if it fits properly, but you don't have an actual body saying, oh, this is too tight, or this is pulling, or too loose. You can also, with this, pull up a tension map, which shows you where the garment is touching the body, where there's a lot of tension. So obviously, across the shoulder, there's going to be some tension because all of your garments always hang from the shoulders. And so I'm expecting to see tension there, but I can also see a lot of tension across the bust. And so I may decide that, well, that's a little tighter than what I really want it to be. So again, in a matter of seconds, I could say, all right, well, I need to come back and I need to adjust this pattern and make it a little bit fuller so that I don't have quite so much tension.
I'm Casey Stannard. I'm a professor here in the area of apparel design. So we have a digital textile printer here, and it's a Mimaki TX300, which is one of the hottest and best digital textile printers on the market. So we use our digital textile printer for printing fabrics that the students design. We can do yardage. We can also print what's called an engineer print, which is where the students actually can put a design into a specific pattern piece so that they can make a design that wraps around the body in a very specific way. So these are some engineered prints that our sophomores put together. And what happened is they actually made these patterns on the computer in our program called OptiTex, and then they were able to put their print within them. And so now what we can do is we can print this out, and we're not gonna have any ink waste in between all these areas where there's no pattern pieces. So it's actually very efficient and very sustainable. Well, this piece of equipment actually represents a completely new avenue of technology within our department. We didn't have the ability to print anything in terms of prints for various textiles before this piece of equipment came in. Now they can actually design in-house and we can get it printed very quickly and efficiently.
Okay, so these two machines behind me are Shimaseki flatbed kneading machines. They're fully computer controlled. So pretty much you just do all your programming and all your design in the computer, and then the computer will convert a program that will actually be readable by the machines. The control, so it will actually run a simulation before the computer, before the machine actually process it, or before the machine actually knit it. So you will do any of the arrow checking or any potential bottleneck kneading or any potential error that might actually interfere with the processing or the manufacturing process. Okay, so this is the program that controls the computer. So pretty much when a designer comes, they just need to know what type of shape that they want, what type of color or what type of design that they want, and then they input all the information within this system. Designers can save this as JPEG or as whatever format and then forward this format to their potential clients for them to decide whether they like the design or not. So this machine, the reason why they are innovative or it's the trend for the future is because they are fully computer controlled. So if you do it manually, the designer has to be really an expert in knitting, whereas if you use this type of technology, as long as you have some sort of knitting background, and then as a designer, then you can do a lot of product from this system.
I'm Pam Vinci, and I am director of the LSU Textile and Costume Museum. This is the new exhibition gallery. Thanks to the Friends of the LSU Textile and Costume Museum and the LSU College of Agriculture, it's been renovated to a space that's appropriate for a textile exhibition. And then the furnishings for the exhibition gallery have been provided through funding from the Louisiana Board of Regents, and they include these wonderful state-of-the-art exhibition cabinets around me that are very lightweight, and can be dismounted, moved to another location, a different configuration, and remounted. And so that's a real plus too. The gallery is currently set up to illustrate the extent of the museum's holdings with selected artifacts from its various collections. And so this is entitled, this exhibition, as the A Look Inside, celebrating 40 years of collecting history and fashion.